Imagine a world without movies. Television. Or even pictures. Where would our entertainment come from? Well, we'd have to settle for books, board games, and the occasional live performance. Our daily lives would be completely changed. The news would be presented in an entirely different fashion. Thankfully, there's such a thing as the camera, which provides the world with all these conveniences and excitement. The camera is involved in so many things in our lives. From the medical field, to law enforcement, to entertainment, cameras rule our world. A series of discoveries throughout the 1600s and 1700s led to the first breakthrough in photography. This breakthrough occurred in 1814, when Joseph Niepce created the first photographic image through the use of camera obscura. The use of the camera obscura was immediately seen as not being a permanent solution, however, as the picture would fade relatively quickly. Progressions in camera technology were obviously needed and continued to occur frequently throughout the 19th century. The processes of daguerreotype, calotype, collodion, and the gelatin dry plate silver bromide process were all invented in the 19th century. Finally, in 1888, the first camera using film was sold. This camera, called the Kodak, was created by George Eastman. Eastman later created the concept of the snapshot with the introduction of Brownie. The vast improvement in cameras continued throughout the 20th century with the introduction of 35mm film. This film was an integral part in making compact cameras capable of creating high-quality margins. The next innovation came in 1928 when SLR cameras were finally made practical with the creation of the Franck and Heidecke Rolleiflex medium format TLR. In 1948, the Polaroid Model 95 appeared on the market as the first instant picture camera. Soon enough, instant color film, autofocus cameras, consumer camcorders, and digital cameras made their way to the market. Still film cameras are a relatively simple contraption consisting of three basic elements: the lens, the film, and the camera body itself. When these three elements are used in cooperation with each other, a recognizable image is formed. By taking a look at an SLR camera, one sees how simple photography really is. The lens of a camera is just a curved piece of glass or plastic that takes the beams of light that bounce off of an object and redirects them so they come together and form a real image. A lens is able to do this because of physics. When light travels from one medium to another, it changes speed. Because light travels more quickly through air than glass, a lens is used to slow it down. As light enters the lens at one angle, it bends in one direction. It bends again upon exiting the glass because parts of the light wave enter the air and speed up before others. In a converging or convex lens, rays of light passing through bend towards the center of the lens upon entry. A converging lens is able to take all the rays of light from an object and converge them all back to one point. Where the rays converge is where a real image is formed. A crucial part of photography is focusing the picture. No one wants to take a blurry picture. When someone focuses a picture, they are actually just moving the lens closer or further away from the film. As you move the lens, you can line up the focus real image of an object so it falls directly on the film surface. Lenses also play a big part in this process. When using a lens that has a flatter surface, the focus real image forms farther away from the one that is round. A flatter lens is able to magnify a small section of scene in front of you because you are seeing a little bit of the huge picture it is actually creating. In turn, a round lens produces a smaller, real image. All that's left now is recording the film. When light hits the paper, the grains undergo a chemical reaction that helps to make the picture. Cameras are used for many things in today's society. These great pieces of technology seem like they are everywhere. That's because they are. They are used for security at businesses and schools. They are also used on traffic lights as a way to catch automotive crime. Hollywood uses them as a way of entertainment, and newspapers and newscasts use them as a way to visualize the news. They can also be found in the medical field, allowing doctors to see down inside patients, among other things. Our social life has revolved around cameras for quite some time as people chat via webcam over the internet and take pictures with one another. Cameras have helped us move into the digital age. Moving to this age is definitely good, but there are also some hazards. Due to cameras being practically everywhere and being able to be any size, people have lost some of the privacy they've had in prior days. People can no longer shop in a store, drive through a traffic light, or go to an amusement park without being recorded by a camera. To me, however, the pros of cameras far outweigh the cons. There are many interesting facts about cameras. First off, is that they improve every year. Just like every other piece of technology, they are always getting better. Another thing that I find interesting is that there are so many different types of memory card storage. Also, in 1998, Sony inadvertently sold more than 700,000 camcorders that allowed a limited ability to see through clothes. It really is amazing how simple the camera really is. The camera uses rules and laws of physics to make our world better. It is responsible for giving us entertainment, making our world safer, and, among other things, helping our doctors solve our illnesses easier. A life without cameras would make our world quite dull and would be a serious inconvenience to almost everyone.